Let's start with our third module. So let's open first terminal here and make our third folder. So mkdir and module 3. So we will find the folder which has been created in this particular directory named as cmake. So let me press enter here and we have found here module 3. Now in this module 3 there is no file, no source file, so let me just copy paste our main.cpp from module 2 and paste it here in module 3. And when I open this main.cpp, as we have seen in the previous lecture, there are four different functions, one for addition, one for subtraction, one for division, and one for multiplication. Now what we will do here is we will define four different C++ files inside this folder. This is our parent folder. Module 3 is our parent folder. So here we will make four different C++ files where we can write our C++ program, where we will define our these functions separately. So let me write a command here. As you can see, there is only main.cpp inside this. So let me first change our directory as cd module 3. And press enter. Now I am inside my module 3 folder, and let me make here my four files, add.cpp, that is just for addition, div.cpp for division, sub.cpp for subtraction, and multi for multiplication, and press enter. Moment I'll press enter, I will find that here in our parent directory there will be four C++ files will be created named as add, div, sub and multi.cpp. So let's press enter and see what happens. As we can see here, we have these four files along with our main.cpp. So let me open all these files so that I can make some changes here. This is my add, as you can see it's empty, and this is my division file, that's also empty right now. Multiplication file, again empty, and subtraction, again empty. Let's first go to the main.cpp and let me copy paste our this function separately in our individual source files. So I am copy pasting here. So you can see that in add.cpp, I am pasting this my function, which is defined previously above our main function in our main file. Now it is separately defined here, and let me copy paste here my subtraction in sub.cpp, and here division in div.cpp, and multiplication for multi.cpp. Now we have defined all these, so let me first save all these files and even main.cpp. Now I have to declare all these, because if I run this program right now, okay, the problem with this main program will be it has nowhere declared this add, because there is no add in the main function. So if I compile this program, our compiler will give an error. Okay, so let me try this. Let's just minimize it, let me save it, and let's try this and see what kind of error arises while compiling. So let me do g++ main.cpp. Let's see what kind of error it throws. So as you can see, add was not declared, sub is not declared, multi is not declared, and div is not declared. So let's go back to our main file and let's define these functions. Let's call these source files which contain these functions in our main file. So let me just copy paste this, copy, and here I am pasting it, put a semicolon, let me copy paste the function over here, division.cpp from, and the last one is multi.cpp. After this one more is left, so let me copy paste my last function, and let's see now what kind of error our compiler throws. So if I again run this function g++ main.cpp, let's see what kind of error it gets. So now this is giving us undefined reference, to all these four functions. So always keep in mind, if you want to run this program, you have to run all the C++ files, all are our source files. So let's see what we have to do. So if I write this and compile this like this, g++ main.cpp, then I have add.cpp, then I have div.cpp, then I have multi.cpp, and then finally I have sub.cpp. Let's see if there is any error thrown by the compiler. So let's press enter now, and as you can see that a.out has been created. Our executable is produced in our parent folder. So one thing is clear, that if I don't declare these functions inside our main program, then it will give us an error. And if I am compiling also, I should compile the main.cpp along with all other cpps which I have created separately. Now the question can be, sir, why we have to define these different files? So when we are designing a very complex program, or when we are designing a complex project, we have different parts of the program which has to be edited in future, like in future. So instead of going through or revising the whole program, we can simply go and edit a particular CPP file, and that will give us our desired outcome. So let's now run our a.out and check if it works perfectly. So it's saying enter the two numbers. So putting here 2 and 3, as you can see, the sum is 5, the division is 0.66, and multiplication is 6, and the subtraction of the two number is -1. So first lecture we found that how to write a program simply, and the second way was the function, and the third way we have seen here using source file. So now we will do one more thing, we will include headers in our next lecture.